And how do you then survive, as you say, sometimes your intuition can be frightened out of you by a director. How do you then deal in a rehearsal situation where the director, you know, in my case, it's John Hirsch. He just drove every creative instinct I ever had out of me, and I was dry and grounded and hanging from the rafters and awful, and I knew it.
Yeah.
How do
but
you deal with that situation?
You weren't awful.
Oh, come on, Rick.
No.
Awful. Even Robert, Lori, my wife, said, Robert, that wasn't the best.
No, I disagree.
I'm sure I got through it one end. You're being very kind. And this is another part of Rick we should talk about.
I'm nodding my head because I went through the same thing with John Hirsch. He told me, you can't act. I'm going, all right, okay, maybe you're right. That's the first thing I want to say. Maybe you're right, you know?
That's the first thing I feel.
Yeah.
He's right, he's smart, he's intelligent.
That's right, he's smart.
He must be
us.
Right. I have no idea how I'm doing this.
Yeah, because we're naturally insecure beings. I think we chose this profession because we can put other people on, you know, literally and figuratively. We can figure them out, maybe figure ourselves out by playing people.
Right, right, hiding.
Yeah.
I go hide inside people.
Oh, yeah. But sometimes, you know, those roles, I was just talking about Sandra, it comes out of you. It just, it flows. When you did the changeling, I thought that was masterful.
Right.
I still remember you coming down the stairs. You had it in your body. There wasn't a toenail that wasn't expressing the character, you know?
Because I had a lot of malevolence bottled up inside me from my adolescence. And as you're talking about, it was stuff that just started coming out. Course.
That's right.
But I wasn't in control of it. Unlike you, saying you have to deal with it and then you can bring it to a piece. I wasn't. I was not as wise as you.
No, it's nothing. The thing, what you're doing, whatever you tapped into in that character, and I remember that, you know, it was Toronto Free or.
Yeah, Toronto Free.
And I said, God, Robert's doing something just absolutely. You just, when you came down the stairs, I said, you knew what, you know. Mm. Your, whether it was the pain, the anguish, or whatever, you were still on top of it. You didn't jump off the stage and slaughter us. That's what I'm talking about.
That's true. I want to talk a little bit about that thing later, but I want to go back to, again, here's John Hirsch, a remarkable, intelligent, and in some ways talented, and in some ways utterly deficient director, who then Hirsches you or removes from you your ability to think that your instincts mean anything. Mm-hmm. How does Rick McMillan then deal with that?
Well, you know, someone walked up to me just about 4 months before I had that experience. I was kind of parachuted into the roles, first of all.
And what were you playing for Hirsch?
I was playing Sir Andrew Agcheek, which I'd done before, and Edgar, which I'd done before. And Joe Ziegler and Nancy were having a baby, so Joe was doing those parts, and he had to go. And this was for the tour when Stratford went to Chicago and all over the States. So I was like, I parachuted in with maybe about a few weeks rehearsal with Hirsch. It was one-on-one.
Douglas Campbell's playing Lear? Who was playing Lear?
Yes, Dougie was, yeah.
It was Douglas Campbell, right.
And I think they asked me because I'd done the roles before. Backing up 4 months prior to that, somebody had told me about working with John. I don't think it was you. I don't. But somebody else had a similar experience.
Yep.
But they said, you know what? Most people act like that are cowards. Stare them in the face, and say, I don't agree with you. I said, what? You want me to say that to John Hirsch? If that should happen, little knowing that later on it would be, because I wasn't working with John up to that point. I played like the King of France, I think, you know, in the beginning of the play. So it was a very tiny, tiny part. So it wasn't easy to replace me with someone else and put me into Joe's part. So during the rehearsal, just myself and Brian Rintoul, he was the assistant director, we had these, you know, intense one-on-ones. And the first day, you know, John's going like this, you know. What's he doing? Then he took me aside, he said, you cannot act. And then I'm going, you're probably right. You're probably right. But then I said, no, I remember what this person said to me 4 months ago. He said, well, you know what I'm going to do, John? I'm going to work on it. Let's see what happens tomorrow. And I don't know where that voice came from, but that's what I said. I came back the next day, and we had a great relationship. I just backed up. I said, no, he was being a bully. In essence, he was being a bully.
But to do that, and I totally admire that, especially because I could not do that. I did not have the wit to do that. And I
4 months prior, I didn't either.
But to do that, you must have had some well of confidence, even though the voice, I'll work on it, John, and come back tomorrow. You did come back tomorrow, and you weren't quaking in your boots, and you did something.
Yeah.
That's a well of confidence that I didn't have.
Well, they just came out of being beat down a lot.
You and the director, John Hirsch, then continued to rehearse, and
everything was fine.
He gave you notes. You worked on that.
It changed. I don't know what happened, just that one little phrase. Next day I came back. I guess I felt a little stronger because I'd said it, and he didn't argue with me.
Right.
And the next day I came back. I said, okay, I'll continue acting that until it becomes real.
And did he give you notes that you could work on?
Oh, yeah. And quite good notes. That surprised the hell out of me, Arch. Surprised the hell out of me. I said, is it that simple? I said, oh. Because before I wouldn't even thought of that. I said, oh, you're probably right. I'm a miserable wretch. I'm lower than swamp scum, you know? You must be right. Because we carry that underneath us. You know, we all, I think most actors do. You know, I don't think we're the most confident people in the world, because I think that's part of the ability of being an actor.